New information in the ongoing investigation of a Popka boater who disappeared in New Smyrna Beach last month and then reappeared on his own last week.
WESH 2 sources now say Enrique Bernardo Hernandez told police he was kidnapped, though the Coast Guard and police say they are still investigating to see what really happened.
Claire Metz reports law enforcement more than 100 miles away is now involved as well.
When 48-year-old Enrique Bernardo Hernandez was reported missing with his boat in these waters, he was presumed dead after an intense four-day search. Turns out at some point between his disappearance February 6th and reappearance March 4th, he was in Avon Park, Highlands County, a county 130 miles southwest of here. Hernandez was questioned by New Smyrna Beach police and the Coast Guard last Friday. He didn't tell them much and refused to answer our questions as he left the police station.
What happened to your boat?
Our sources tell us Hernandez is claiming he was kidnapped, but doesn't know how he wound up in Avon Park or where his boat is. So now, in addition to other law enforcement, Highlands County Sheriff's deputies want anyone who may have seen Hernandez in Avon Park to come forward. We've also learned it was an acquaintance in Avon Park who drove Hernandez back to Apopka last week, where we caught up with him, breaking the case wide open that Hernandez was alive and well.
We would like just know where he's at. We're very worried.
If Hernandez's month-long disappearance was planned, his family didn't seem to be in on it. His son, wife, and other relatives held vigil in New Smyrna Beach for days while rescuers searched the river and ocean, from the ground, by air, an exhaustive and expensive effort. Now, the effort is to learn what really happened, and if it was all in vain, that could mean new trouble for Hernandez. The Coast Guard, heading this investigation, has told us that if Hernandez was trying to pull one over for whatever reason when he disappeared, he could face charges. In Volusia County, Claire Metz, WESH 2 News.